In the misty realms of history, a child was born into a family of witches. A child who would grow to become an icon of modern witchcraft.
My name is Sybil Leek.
I am a witch, and I follow an ancient occult pre-Christian religion of witchcraft.
It is the mother goddess, the goddess of nature, that we worship.
Every century, every generation has always needed a shoulder to cry upon. The witches of the world have been the psychologists, the healers, the doctors, the midwives, and very often the neighboring good friend who could do just a little more for a person.
In the early 20th century, precisely in the year of 1917, a baby girl was welcomed into the world by a well-off English family. This family was not just notable for their wealth or status, but for a lineage that traced back through generations of witches. This child, named Sybil Leek, was born into a destiny that was as mysterious as it was profound. Sybil's story roots itself in the verdant expanses of New Forest, England. This was a place where the old ways were still respected, a place where legends and lore held sway over the minds of the local populace.
Are there very many witches about?
Well, I think you would be very, very surprised if you knew how many initiated witches there are in the whole world. And not only that, there's a very great following in witchcraft.
Of course the young are interested in witchcraft. And I think this is a very, very healthy thing in today's age. Because we have very special people born today in the young people. I call them the Pluto people. They have inquiring minds. They're seekers. And they're not hung up on the inhibitions that their parents and grandparents had. They're aware of psychic forces and psychic energy and occultism. But they're not just going to accept it. They want to know. They're probing all the time.
It was here that Sybil's grandmother, a well-known witch of the area, took the young girl under her wing. Sybil's grandmother was a woman of wisdom and power, a figure who commanded respect not just for her knowledge of herbs and healing, but for her deep understanding of the mystical arts. It was under this strong, guiding hand that Sybil was introduced to the world of witchcraft. Her lessons were not confined to the pages of dusty books or old scrolls. No, Sybil was taught in the heart of the forest, amidst the whispering trees and the enchanting chorus of nature. She was taught to listen to the wind, to speak to the spirits of the earth, and to draw power from the moon and stars.
Take me.
Sybil's childhood was an enchanting mix of normalcy and mysticism. While she attended school and played with friends like any other child, her nights and weekends were spent learning the secrets of the old ways. This dichotomy, this blending of the mundane and the magical, would come to define Sybil's life and her approach to witchcraft. In the misty realms of history, a child was born into a family of witches, a child who would grow to become an icon of modern witchcraft, Sybil Leek. Thus, the stage was set for Sybil, a child born of witchcraft, to walk a path both extraordinary and mystical. As Sybil blossomed into a teenager, her life took a turn that would mark the beginning of her extraordinary journey. With her unconventional behavior becoming more pronounced, Sybil found herself at odds with the strictures of private schooling. It was during these formative years that Sybil's unique spirit began to shine, proving too bright for the confines of traditional education. Expelled from multiple schools, she was a wildflower refusing to be pruned, her spirit refusing to be tamed.
This is also the time when we ourselves will be feeling a great need to renew the energy of our occult powers within ourselves to carry us through for the rest of the year.
I know I'll be back again taking an interest in things. And you know what? Even if you don't believe in reincarnation, you'll be there too.
I always accepted that reincarnation as a fact.
You do believe in
that
reincarnation?
That the spirit is indestructible.
Sybil's early adulthood was marked by a series of marriages, each one an adventure in its own right. Her first marriage was a whirlwind romance that was tragically cut short by the ravages of World War II. The loss of her first husband was a devastating blow, a heartache that would echo throughout her life. In the aftermath of her loss, Sybil sought solace in nature. She retreated into the New Forest, a place of ancient oaks and mystical lore. There, amongst the whispering trees and the rustling leaves, Sybil found a connection to something bigger than herself. She immersed herself in the local gypsy community, a group of people who embraced her eccentricity and shared her reverence for the natural world. They lived on the fringes of society, much like Sybil herself, and in them, she found kindred spirits. Time in the New Forest was a period of profound self-discovery. Living amongst the gypsies, she delved deeper into the ancient practices of her ancestors, practices that had been passed down through generations. She learned about herbs and their healing properties, about the cycles of the moon and the power of intention.
Mrs. Sybil Leek. She's a housewife and mother. She's 41. She's an antique dealer and a self-confessed white witch. Now that means that she uses her powers for good and not for evil. She says that she could do all the frightening things, like sticking pins in effigies and bringing curses down on people's heads, but she doesn't. And yet, basically, the meetings or services or sabbats, as they're called, are exactly the same, whether they're for black or white. Now tonight, the witches and the warlocks will be meeting at such a sabbat. What will they be doing and why?
Taking part in just one of the four great sabbats which witches have always done for thousands of years. We shall be doing it because Halloween is quite important to us as a religious ceremony. It's the time of the year when the fire of the sun is dwindling, and of course we don't want this to happen. And it is also the time when we ourselves will be feeling a great need to renew the energy of our occult powers within ourselves to carry us through for the rest of the year.
It is the sun goddess that you worship, is it?
No, it is the mother goddess, the goddess of nature, that we worship. But of course, fire is quite important in nature.
They're all a bunch of little toads in a pot that Fiona is slowly bringing to a boil. You won't even feel it until it's too late. I'd rather burn than boil.
These teachings resonated deeply with Sybil, and she began to understand her place in the world and her purpose. It was in the New Forest, amidst the gypsies and the ancient oaks, that Sybil Leek began to embrace her destiny. She was not just Sybil, the unconventional teenager, the war widow, the wildflower. She was Sybil Leek, a descendant of a long line of wise women. A woman who would become a beacon for those seeking knowledge of the old ways. Amidst personal loss and societal norms, Sybil found solace in the ancient practices of her ancestors. In the heart of the New Forest, Sybil found her calling, living among the gypsies and embracing her witchy heritage.
You know, politicians from all over the world still beat a path to my door, secretly.
What do they want to find out?
Everything you can possibly think of. I tell them to the best of my ability what I think would be helpful, not always what they want to hear. I must be something in this dimension. I must see the beauty in this dimension. I reject nothing in this life. Nothing at all.
So this is a fascinating point here, that there's an impression perhaps of witches in the 20th century is that it's a cop-out, if you know what I mean.
Yes, it's not. It is not.
Certain evangelists. Mm-hmm. Who are laying on of hands.
Yes, now,
you don't suspect
it is not, this. No. Now, this is one thing that intrigues me, particularly in America, because everyone in America seems to be looking for an escape hatch. And the one thing that witchcraft is not is an escape hatch. It demands of you, and you have to give. And it is no substitute for personal endeavor. But the wonderful thing is
But the magic of it all is it helps to extend your horizons. It helps you to be a little more than yourself. It takes you along wonderfully adventurous paths in a much more interesting way. And you've really got one eye in one world and one in the other. And so life is an adventure. You very rarely meet an unhappy witch in the 20th century.
In the land of the free, Sybil found a new home and a new audience for her witchcraft. Sybil Leek, the British witch, exiled from her homeland, was embraced by America with open arms. Her arrival in the late 60s marked the beginning of an exciting chapter in her life. It was here that Sybil transitioned from a misunderstood witch to a respected lecturer and author, shaping the American perception of witchcraft. In America, she found a society willing to listen, eager to learn, and open to the mysteries of the craft. From universities to public forums, Sybil shared her knowledge and experiences, debunking myths and unfurling the true essence of witchcraft. Her lectures were often filled with intriguing tales of her life, her spells, and her beliefs, which captivated audiences across the country. Her journey didn't stop at lectures. Sybil took pen to paper and authored several books that became instrumental in spreading the understanding of witchcraft. Her first book, Diary of a Witch, published in 1968, offered a personal glimpse into the life and practices of a witch. It broke many stereotypes and laid the groundwork for the acceptance of witchcraft as a legitimate and respected path. Her subsequent books, including Complete Art of Witchcraft, Sybil Leek's Book of Herbs, and Sybil Leek's Book of Curses, further expanded the horizons of witchcraft in America. These books not only educated, but also inspired a new generation of witches and wizards. Sybil's influence stretched beyond the pages of her books. She was a regular on talk shows and radio programs, where she would discuss witchcraft with curiosity, humor, and a deep sense of respect for the craft. She was a beacon of light in a world often shrouded in misunderstanding and fear. Her work in America led to a significant shift in the perception of witchcraft.
Well, let me ask you, what is witchcraft?
For me, it's a religion, and nothing...
Dating back to the Druid period?
Yes, I'm a Druid. And it goes well back to the time when men were just thinking there must be something greater than themselves.
Even then, in this concept, yes, there was a feeling of a greater power.
There has to be something greater than us.
She was instrumental in the revival and acceptance of witchcraft, paving the way for a more inclusive and understanding society. Sybil Leek, once an outcast, had become a respected figure in the world of witchcraft.
And I'm not anti-religious. I think I'm anti-hypocrisy.
I agree with you.
I think if you're a Roman Catholic, be a very good Roman Catholic. If you're a Protestant, be a very good Protestant.
As the sun set on Sybil's extraordinary life, she left behind a legacy that continues to inspire. In the autumn of 1982, the world bid farewell to a remarkable woman who had touched many lives. Sybil Leek, the British witch, had journeyed from the mystical realms of New Forest to the bustling streets of America, shaping the course of modern witchcraft with her teachings. Her journey was not without hardship, but she remained stalwart, her spirit unbroken. Sybil's passing was not the end of her story. Rather, it was the beginning of her legacy. Her teachings didn't fade with her passing, but instead, they flourished, inspiring a new generation of witches and those curious about witchcraft to embrace the craft and its rich history. Even today, her books continue to be revered as essential reading for any witchcraft enthusiast. Her teachings, brimming with wisdom and authenticity, have encouraged countless individuals to explore their own spiritual paths. They offer a unique perspective, a testament to her life's journey, and serve as a guide for those embarking on their own journey into the world of witchcraft. Sybil's influence extends beyond her written work. She was a beacon of resilience, an advocate for authenticity, and a champion of the craft. Her life, her teachings, and her indomitable spirit continue to inspire witches and non-witches alike, encouraging them to live authentically and fearlessly. Sybil's legacy is not confined to her contributions to the world of witchcraft. It is also found in the hearts of those she inspired, the minds of those she educated, and the spirit of those she empowered. Her legacy is a testament to her life, a life lived with passion, authenticity, and resilience. Born into a world that was skeptical of her beliefs, she grew up to be a beacon of light for those who dared to delve into the realm of the mystical and unknown. Her transformation was not a sudden one, but a journey that spanned across continents, cultures, and decades. From being a solitary witch in the New Forest, she became an acclaimed author and lecturer in America, sharing her knowledge and wisdom about witchcraft. She was not just a practitioner, but a symbol of resilience and courage. She challenged the stereotypes, faced adversity with grace, and carved a niche for herself in a world that was quick to judge her. In a world that sought to silence her, Sybil Leek found her voice and used it to illuminate the path for others, forever transforming the world of witchcraft.